A Tale of Two Birds. This lesson is from the supplementary reader, A Pact with the Sun, grade 6. There once lived a bird and her two newborn babies in a forest. They had a nest in a tall shady tree, and there the mother bird took care of her little ones day and night. One day there was a big storm. There was thunder, lightning and rain. The wind blew down many trees. The tall tree in which the birds lived also came down. The big heavy branch hit the nest and killed the bird. Fortunately for the baby birds, the strong wind blew them away to the other side of the forest. One of them came down near a cave where a gang of robbers lived. The other landed outside a rishi's ashram a little distance away. Once there lived a bird and her two newborn babies in a forest. The mother bird built her nest on a tall shady tree. The mother bird took care of her little ones day and night. Suddenly one day there was a big storm. There was thunder, lightning and rain. The wind blew very fast and blew down many trees. The tree in which the mother bird built her nest also came down, and one of the branch which broke hit the nest and killed the mother bird. Luckily, the two baby birds were thrown away to the other side of the forest. Now begins the story, which teaches you a lesson of how the behavior changes in every living thing. Here it is compared to the change in behavior of the two birds. Among the two baby birds, one fell near a cave where a gang of robbers lived. The other baby bird landed outside a rishi's ashram, which was a little distance away. Days passed and the baby birds became big birds. One day, the king of the country came to the forest to hunt. He saw a deer and rode after it. It ran deep into the forest, followed by the king. Soon the king lost his way and didn't know where he was. He rode on for a long time till he came to the other side of the forest. Very tired by now, he got off his horse and sat down under a tree that stood near a cave. Suddenly he heard a voice cry out, "Quick, hurry up, there's someone under the tree. Come and take his jewels and his horse. Hurry, or else he'll slip away." The king was amazed. He looked up and saw a big brown bird on the tree under which he was sitting. He also heard faint noises issuing from the cave. He quickly got on to his horse and rode away as fast as he could. Here, the baby bird started observing the people around them. The bird near the cave learned what the gang of robbers did, and the other, which lived near the ashram, learned all good things the sages did. Days passed, months passed, and the bird started to grow bigger. One day, the king of the country came to the forest for hunting. He saw a deer and rode after it. Seeing the king, the deer ran deep into the forest. The king followed it, but soon lost his way and didn't know where he was. He rode for a long time till he reached the other side of the forest. He got very tired and got off his horse, and he sat down under a tree which was near the cave. Suddenly he heard someone telling, "Hurry up." The king heard a sound from the tree. Can you guess whose sound it was? Yes, it was the bird's sound. To the king's surprise, it started to speak. It informed the robbers about the jewels the king had and also about the horse. It also said the robbers to hurry up or else the king would escape. The king slowly looked up the brown bird that was sitting on the tree. The king also heard some noise from the cave. He got up quickly and rode his horse as fast as he could. Soon he came to a clearing which looked like an ashram. It was the rishi's ashram. The king tied his horse to a tree and sat down in its shade. Suddenly, he heard a gentle voice announce, "Welcome to the ashram, sir. Please go inside and rest. The rishi will be back soon. There's some cold water in the pot. Please make yourself comfortable." The king looked up and saw a big brown bird in the tree. He was amazed. "This one looks like the other bird outside the cave," he said to him loudly. "You're right, sir," answered the bird. "He is my brother, but he has made friends with robbers. He now talks as they do," He doesn't talk to me anymore. Just then, the rishi entered the ashram. Here, the king rode fast and reached the ashram. It was a rishi's ashram. As the king was too tired, he wanted to take rest. Near the ashram, the king saw a tree. So, he went down and sat in its shade. Suddenly, he heard a gentle voice. He turned around. Now, can you guess who it was? You're right. It was the brown bird which was brought up in the ashram. Looking at the bird, the king got surprised because the bird gave a warm welcome and requested the king to take rest. The bird informed that the rishi will come back soon. Meanwhile, the bird asked the king to drink some cold water which was in the pot and also asked him to comfort himself. The king was surprised to see the brown bird which was same as the one he saw outside the cave. So he started to speak to himself about the birds. Hearing the king, the brown bird which was in Rishi's ashram said that the other brown bird was his brother. He also said that he had made friends with the robbers and now talks as they do. While the bird was talking to the king, the rishi entered. "Welcome, sir," he said to the king. "Please come inside and make yourself at home. You look tired. Rest for a while. Then you can share my food." The king told the rishi the story of the two birds and how each have behaved so differently, though they looked so alike. "The forest is full of surprises," he said. The holy man smiled and said, "After all, one is known by the company one keeps. That bird has always heard the talk of robbers. He imitates them and talks about robbing people. This one has repeated what he has always learnt. He welcomes people to the ashram. Now, come inside and rest. I'll tell you more about this place and these birds." Here, the rishi gave a warm welcome to the king and requested him to take rest and later also wished to share his food. The king told the rishi about the change in the birds' behavior, though they looked alike. The king said that the forest was full of surprises. The holy man, that is the rishi, smiled and said that one is known by his company. The bird in the cave imitated, that means followed and did whatever the robbers did. And the bird in the ashram always heard good words and learned to welcome the people. Finally, the rishi invited the king inside to take rest and also was willing to give more information about the place and the birds. So students, one is known by the company one keeps. Join with good friends, learn good habits, respect the feeling of others and always try to help people when they are in need. Once again I repeat, one is known by the company one keeps. Students, feel good by doing good.